When I came to Maine Medical Center as a resident, I came here in part because I knew they probably wouldn't make me do research. I found that I couldn't answer the questions that I was being asked. So the families and the patients would ask me, what's the best treatment for this? Or what's the reason for what's happened to this person? I didn't know because there was no answer, not because I didn't know it or because I hadn't learned it, but because the limits to our science were incredibly apparent in the day-to-day practice of clinical medicine.
Had I not been able to have a job with a significant portion of my time allocated to research, I would not have been able to create or build the program that I've built, and I wouldn't be able to provide the service that I'm providing to these families.
What we've seen in the past few years is the goals that were completely unattainable. When I was a postdoctoral fellow, these goals were just, you know, there were throwaway lines in grant applications. One day we will be able to generate some kidney tissue. And it's only 10 years and we're here.
I think, you know, one thing was being nominated for the New England Journal. I think that was a big moment for me. It was totally unexpected, phone call and then an interview. And that's been one of the greatest experiences of my medical career. The decisions we make in the editorial board at Harvard every week decide how clinical medicine is practiced.
The research that's being done right now at Maine Medical Center in the Neurological Intensive Care Unit is completely cutting edge stuff. It involves almost every aspect of care that we provide.
The SWIFT Prime study was looking at whether we could take patients who have very bad stroke, so the worst of our stroke population. We are now, instead of getting 30 to 40% of our patients independent after a major stroke, 60 to 70% of our patients with the techniques that we use in the SWIFT Prime trial are fully independent. And that is a once in a generation result, and we are really proud to have been part of it.
We want the people in our community to understand research and its implications. We want the students to have great experiences here. And we want this to lead to something that the community can be proud of.
The research we've done with our inpatient program particularly has really put us on the national map. And Spring Harbor and Maine Health specifically has gotten national press on this effort. And we've had teams from all over the country come and visit our program. And in fact, had a team from Africa come and visit our program. And I was just on the phone with a team from Australia who wants to know what we're doing. Our relationship with our autism funding organizations has been close. When we proposed to them that we're going to do large projects, run them, and ask these foundations for millions of dollars, they have to have confidence in me, but they also have to have confidence in the larger institution that is behind this project. And we've been able to really communicate that.
I think I was a much better doctor now than I was when I finished my training. And it has nothing to do with the knowledge base, which we can now all pick up electronically. But really it has to do with what you said, the scientific discipline in which you approach a problem.
And I think one of the worst things that physicians face right now is burnout. And I often tell people that the research that I'm doing is protective against burnout because it fuels my enthusiasm.
One of my goals is to be able to provide these experiences for students. And if I change somebody's life one day or shape their career path or help them discover their passion, then that's a really good day.
For me, when a patient walks through my door, I want to know that I'm providing the most contemporary care on par with anywhere in the world for that patient. And I think in my area of work in neurosurgery, unless one's involved with answering some of the unanswered questions that exist for almost every disorder we treat, I think one is not providing the most contemporary care for that patient.
When you think of how fast science is accelerating, I think right now, there's a good reason to be optimistic.
We've gone from being somewhat stagnant, I would say, in terms of the treatments that we provide, to always looking to do something better, more cutting edge, and more effective than what we were doing before. And it's exciting. It's an exciting place to work. And I think the excitement comes from seeing the patients do better than they used to do, and watching them walk back into the unit when they should be dead. And people love that.
I've told somebody recently that I love doing research so much that I would rather do research on constipation if it meant doing research than not do research.